Good morning, teacher. The same lesson we have had. The last period we studied about how time is measured, what things were useful. Again, we studied about today's newspaper. It becomes tomorrow. It becomes past. That we studied why newspapers are very important. We can collect that newspaper and keep it safe. We can understand the past events which took place many years ago by the help of newspapers. Nowadays we have different kind of medias are there, electronic media, print media, and other facilities are there. So we can preserve many things. We have a good qualities of mobiles with us. Many things we can preserve on mobile also. But many years ago, the situation was totally different. We were not able to preserve that things. So newspapers were a very important means. We used to know the past information by the help of newspapers. Then we moved to how to understand the time. Time was divided. We studied in last lesson, that is in last lecture, that time is divided into seconds, minutes, hours, days and night, fortnight, month and year. And what were the instruments of measuring time? That I told in last period. That is, water clock was there, and calendars. These were the importance to measure the time. Now, we have to understand, in 14th century, the hourglass came into existence. Hourglass. It came into existence in 14th century. In which country this hourglass exists? Which country started use of this hourglass? That was in European nation it started. European countries this use of hourglass started. Now how is this hourglass? It is consisted of two connected glass vessels fitted into the wooden frame. Two glass vessels fitted into the wooden frame. These are two glass vessels which are fitted into the wooden plate. Dry fine sand was poured into the one of the vessel. Now, in this vessel, dry sand was put or poured. Dry sand was put in this. And there was a connecting hole for these two vessels. Now in this vessel, dry sand was put. There was a connecting hole. We can see here a connecting hole to these two vessels. These are two vessels. This is vessel one. Vessel one. And this is vessel two. Sand was put in vessel 1. It was put in vessel 1. There was space for going. The vessel will be filled in this, and slowly it was pouring down, it was coming down. It was falling down. The hourglass was constructed in a such way that it took 1 hour for all the sand to fall from one vessel to another. Now, these are the two vessels. Sand was put in vessel number one. The time required vessel, this sand vessel too, was complete one hour. Such kind of adjustment was done. Understand it properly. Now this, again I am repeating, this is vessel number 1 and this is vessel number 2. In vessel number 1, sand, a dry sand was put. Dry sand was put in vessel number 1. And the time which was required for this sand to come down in vessel number 2, it was of 1 hour that adjustment was done. So, by the help of this, we were understand. There the people were understanding. We also are understanding that a required time to reach this sand down was 1 hour. Means after completing, this vessel number 2 was filled, then people came to know that 1 hour is completed. Same way, the vessel was changed. The vessel number 2 was done up and from 2 the sand was coming down. That is, that was second hour, third hour. Such way they understood the time, what time was there and how much hours they are completed today. Next. So By the help of this vessel, that is our vessel, people were knowing that after completing this sand, when the sand was reaching in vessel number 2, 1 hour was completed. According simultaneously, they were changing that. From second number vessel, the sand was coming in first, again they were changing and they were knowing how much hours they have completed. Now this was about an hourglass. I think every student have understood. You can see in page number 31, an hourglass is shown, water clock is shown and calendar is shown. Below that you can find one assignment is given to you that every student of third standard will do. Stick a photograph of yourself from the past, present in the frame. Below, in the frame of the future, draw a picture of what you will look like after 20 years. Now, first you can see past, when you were baby, of just 1 year or 2 years, if you are having that kind of photo, you can paste in frame 1. And right now you are in third standard, take out one photo, paste it in present, and what you do, take a small paper, draw your own picture after 20 years, how you will look, and that you paste in third number frame. So, till here we are finished. Next topic we'll study of same lesson, because we are going to go very slowly. Already we are towards third lesson, completion of third lesson. We have only total 5 lessons of geography. So, study properly, read that books at home, whatever assignments are given, writing work is given, what you can write, that you can do it by yourself. And from our side, we are going to provide you some pictures, photographs of workbooks. You have to complete that workbook as well as notebook at home. Thank you and have a nice day.